Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl Hannah, and today's video will be me speaking on how to love yourself and how to build self-confidence and also self-esteem. Now I'll be sharing my experiences, well, some. But yeah, so please like, share, and subscribe, and let's get into this video. I struggled for many years with having low self-esteem, and learning to love myself. And self-confidence also. Well, self-confidence and self-esteem fall into the same bracket for me, but yeah. But I really struggled for many years, and I still struggle with it up to today at times. Well, now I'm not as bad as I used to. Well, used to be, I mean, but I trying by God's grace. I remember when I was in elementary school, some call it primary school in my country, but yeah, I mean we call it primary school in my country, but yeah, elementary school, I really struggled with believing in myself and having high self-esteem. It really messed with my grades, because I always used to fail or get low grades, and it continued and carried on to when I was in high school or secondary school. I struggled with it for so many years, and when I look back, it's like all the feelings that I used to feel before, I feel it back when I look back on that these times. And everyone would be telling me, my mom and everybody else would be telling me, I have to believe in myself and you know, so on. But I really struggled with it. And for me, I will say that when you do not love yourself, there are so many other disadvantages when it comes to the rest of your being, like you. I will say, because I didn't love myself, my self-esteem was low. I don't have self-confidence. I'm so much more like that's like the main source. So long you do not love yourself, it's like you're not even being your real self, I would say. Because, yeah, it's like you're just limiting yourself. That is why it's so important to love yourself. Let me use an example. God's love. God loves us, his children, so much. He loves everybody so much. If you do not have God, you cannot do anything in life. If he is not the foundation of your life, you cannot achieve anything in life. Because on your own, you are nothing without God. The same way when it comes to loving yourself. If you do not love yourself, you cannot do nothing. Because you loving yourself really elevates you. And now I am actually learning step by step how to love myself fully. And God is the one who's helping me with this. It's by His love, His grace, His mercies that I am finally learning how to love myself. Man, honestly, I look at like so much. Like, I've like survived, I would say, or overcome. It's God's love for me. Even when I didn't even love myself, it's God's love that really kept me. His grace kept me, His mercies kept me, His patience kept me. The first thing on how you can actually love yourself is to accept God's love for you. Accept that He loves you, like absorb that He loves you, like absorb His love. When you have His love, you'll be able to love yourself true, with that true love, with that unconditional love. Because His love is so true, it's so pure, it is so righteous. So that is how I'm really learning how to love myself. And I will tell you this: you not loving yourself, it drains you. You cannot really do anything because, like, that main source is empty. It's like you're lacking it. Sometimes it puts you in situations, like you not loving yourself puts you in situations, or like it makes you do like make decisions that just it costs you so much. Because it cost me peace, it cost me life. I know it's not good to regret. And I would say that even though with all of these things, when I look back, instead of regretting it, just start fresh. I cannot restart or change what happened, but I can start a new chapter and change the ending. You know, YouTube, although there are so many reasons why I started YouTube. YouTube is really helping me to love myself more. Self-love is one of the greatest gifts you can give to yourself. Because when you really love yourself, you will see it from inside out. You will see that you love yourself. When you not love yourself, you'll also see it on the outside too. But really, YouTube has really changed me. Like, from that very short space of time, it really ch changed me. And yes, I did three videos to seek help, etc., for my health trip to Colombia. But doing these other videos, exercising, this really helps. It boosts my confidence and self-esteem. Yes, I know that I don't get many views and many likes, but it's like I don't really care about that, to be honest. It's like me just knowing that my experiences, my testimonies, people actually watch it. And even though they may not like or share it, or you know, so much more. Like, at least I know deep down that it ministers to some people. So this really helps me. I thank God that He gives me His strength and His wisdom, His knowledge, His understanding to really do what I'm doing. I will admit, and I will share this, me not loving myself put me in a phase, because I loved other people more than I actually loved myself. And that is one of the most, I don't even know what's the right word to use, but like, that's one of the most dangerous things I have ever done. And yes, I blame myself and I beat up myself so much, people don't even know. But seeing how much I really loved some people, I loved them more than I even loved myself. And in the end, I still got hurt. But you know what? Even though I loved them more than I loved myself, I knew it was pure love. Because now when I look back on that love that I have for them, I don't hate them. I really don't. I still love them. It really helps me to see how much I can love myself, especially with God's love. God is really, really, really helping me to love myself. And my relationship with Him is so beneficial to me, because I can tell Him openly, like wholeheartedly, open-hearted, if that's even a word, how I feel, what I struggle with, and so much more. And He won't even judge me. He listens to me. He wants to help me, and He helps me. He helps me by speaking to me, whether it be through a song, through a movie, through a testimony, through His word. He helps me. So if you want to, if you are struggling with self-love, self-confidence, and self-esteem, first thing you gotta do is accept God's love. And believe God's love. Whenever you accept His love and you ask Him to teach you how to love yourself also, He will help you and you will love yourself. Slowly, slowly, one step at a time, He will. Because He did it for me and I know that He can do it for you. Life experiences all... How will I put that one? Like, okay. Not everybody experience or like the same, okay. I'm trying to use an example, but I can't really think of a good example to use. All right. Let's use diet. Right? But not just diet, but foods. Not all food that every single soul eat, or that or one person eat, that everybody else has to eat. Especially if they're trying to improve their health, their diet, etc. Because not every food works for everybody. Not everything works for everybody. But I know one thing that do works for everybody is God. He works for everybody because He's all powerful and so such an amazing God. So if I cannot encourage someone, not even encourage, but like tell someone like something in this world, a materialistic thing that can help them. One thing I know for sure, and one person I know for sure that can help them is God. Because he knows exactly how to. He might not, for me, I will not know how to. Or it might look so difficult for me to really understand how to. But he knows exactly how to. So this is my encouragement to everyone. On self-love, self-acceptance, well, confidence, sorry. And also self-acceptance can really fall into these two. I guess it wanted to be there too. You see, God has a way of just letting things flow and do what he wants to do. For you to accept yourself, accept God's version of you. Because that's your true vision of yourself. How God sees you, how God views you, how God, how should I say, describes you, etc. Accept that person. And accept your true self. Accept yourself, flaws and all. You are not perfect, no one is perfect. But by God's grace, with his help, we will be perfect one day. Only by his help, only by his grace we will be one day. But on our own, we can never be perfect. So yes, accept yourself. Accept his love. And you will have self-love, self-confidence. And so much more. You really accept who God sees you as, you learn so much things about yourself that you don't even knew that was you, I would say. Because you are amazing. Every one of us are amazing, special, unique, beautiful, handsome. And so much more. Like, God speaks so highly of us. So, he is the great source that can really help us have self-esteem, self-love, self-acceptance, self-confidence. He is our manufacturer. So, he's the best source. But anyways, guys, have a great day. Night for those who are have like it's night for them, for you all, I mean. And love you guys. Stay tuned for more videos with me, your girl Hannah. And yeah, now I have some playlists, so I might be doing another video also, like after this one, to add to another one. But yeah, so this will just be an encouragement. So yes, but I love y'all guys. Like, share, and subscribe, turn on that notification bell, and stay tuned for more videos with me. Love you always. Peace.